every day there was a sign that was like, the baby elephant is next to the mama elephant. Mm-hmm. Say it in English and Spanish. And like, every day they would get that routine bit of it, which we're not going to be doing this year.
Yeah.
It's different. So we'll have to build it in some way. It could be on the bathroom.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Okay.
Those signs are already exist.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Just copy paste.
Level standards on this actual entomological assessment. Also, side note, the unit is shorter, so there's no mid module,
yeah.
Just the entomodule.
Yeah,
that's our next part. We'll get there. So, entomodule assessment, is there anything that we missed that students are going to be able to need, students are going to need to be able to do by the end of this year?
Yes. Mm-hmm. They get to be able to talk about why shapes are the same and different. Am I wrong?
No, you're good.
Tell me about your groups. What's the same about the groups and what's different? They're usually really good at saying what's different about the groups, but they have a really hard time telling you what's the same about them.
I'm going to put that under misconceptions.
Which also thinks about like how are they going to show me that in an assessment that.
Yeah. How to assess all the talking they'll do in a whole group assessment.
At my last school, they did it had like 4 or 5 content questions. So it would be, we'd have to like describe the shape and it would take like 2 minutes each day.
Okay.
And then the rest of the whole group. Like it was two different, it was two separate. Like, was
two different assessments?
Conferencing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Which it was like kind of annoying because it was just wrong, but
right.
They addressed these.
Yeah.
So now you have to read the word like next to the side.
Yeah. Because, yeah. What? No,
I'm just thinking about the three-dimensional section, topic B, and they, I think, like, part of the reason that they're successful there is that they can, like, hold it and feel it, and, like, how do you know that the cylinder is different from the cone? And they, like, a lot of them touch the pointy part, and they're, like, it's pointy here, you know, and like, I worry that if they don't have something in their hands to be tactile with, it's a little bit more abstract, and they might not have as much success.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I'm trying to have all the materials.
But even for the assessment, you know, because on paper, they don't need that.
Right.
Need that scholar and such.
You are right.
I was thinking to your point about the same, like them talking about what's the same between shapes. I think that's been something so hard for them, and so being proactive about that as you're teaching, and as you're teaching sorting, as you're teaching differences and classifying shapes, like all of that, trying to go back to like, but what's the same about them? And I would love to hear what people think as correct answers, but like, that they're all flat shapes, that they're all shapes, that they're all 2D, that they're all 3D. What are other answers for? Like I'm thinking about topic A as a question, how they're all the same.
I think something we get more
topic
on
C.
Is, sometimes they say they're the same color, and like, I'll be okay with that answer.
I think so. Right?
It doesn't talk about like shape kind of the same, so I don't know if that's like the side of the issue, but if you're asking them what's the same, and they see that the color is
Leanna,
do you have another?
Yeah, I was agreeing with Connor. But then, are we saying Connor off the paper or are we saying Connor when they actually have something in their hand? Because it
gonna leave that to Diamond to see what she does and try to talk to her about how to make this into a whole group assessment. Any other thoughts on what they need to do, what misconceptions they'll have? I think same is definitely a big one.
Do they need to build shapes again? Like build a hexagon or shapes?
Not yet.
Okay.
Great question. It's
I saw like they're like doing attribute boards.
Yeah.
But I wasn't sure if they were.
It comes at the end of the year. So we do one other unit on geometry.
Gotcha. Okay. I didn't
and that's where they start to compose and decompose. Yeah. One thing I thought about is making sure that, like, going back to Perry's original point about like how they see shapes in real things, is trying to point that out starting now. Like Carlos Blanco used to do such a great job of this, would be like, bring my rectangular prism of a phone to me, please. Or like, make sure that you put it in the Unite cylinder jar. Like, pointing out especially solid shapes, because those are something harder for them. So I'm just looking around the room and now thinking about shapes that you could say, like, Gabe's sleeping in his rectangular prism of a bed. Those kind of things. And if you have stuff that you can bring out, like, water bottles, your like Tupperware lunch, have it out so that you have the opportunity to say that.
And I'm thinking about how that supports in one of the questions. It then works in, it's like, if I point to something in this room that's the same solid shape as this, mm-hmm. and like if you show them a cylinder and you've been pointing out that your water bottle is a cylinder for the last 3 weeks, then they're like, oh, I know something that's the same shape as that.
Bring out the shapes in real life and cross with them in mind throughout the day. Okay. Thinking about next steps and what Tanisha already said is Unit 2 and Unit 3 don't have exit slips right now. Diamond said the rationale there is because a lot of these lessons have a more hands-on and often a longer problem set. Not longer, but just like the amount of time it takes to get through concept development and problem set. It's something that I will follow up on Thursday about and ask more like what we're doing there. Especially because I think we've like gotten into and like are working in this routine of problem set and exit ticket. Thoughts. They do not exist right now. What do you think?
This makes it a little harder. So like, that's not like, basically like, so it seems like a lot of oral under the non-Christian like assessing. So they don't have like, if I can't refer to something on paper for each student, it makes it a little different.
Yeah.
So, like, maybe I should target.
Yeah.
And not very difficult.
And I think it's like structurally too, it makes sense to start to set up some sort of schedule where there's different steps to the lesson.
Yeah.
And they know what to expect now.
Right.
I mean, I don't know if there's a way to cut down on all the things that they're doing during the problem set and make a little bit more time, or even take a section of the problem set and turn it into the exit ticket.
Mm-hmm.
Like they only do the first section during the problem set time and then they leave it on their table and then they come back. The second part is the exit ticket. I know the exit tickets are typically a little bit less, they're just a little more pared down, so I don't know if that would work.
The problem sets for the following week are, I wouldn't say simple, but they don't have multiple pages like the first module did.
Mm.
Like, if I'm looking at problem number 4 right now, it's like circle, they have the color. Find the circles and color them green, find the hexagons and color them yellow. Put an X on the shapes that are not hexagons and circles. That's lesson 4.
That's the whole problem set.
Mm-hmm.
oh, that's for the first top part, and then the second part is draw hexagons and circles.
So I'm just wondering if, like,
there we go.
Yeah, could they do the first part as a prop set and the second part of it as the end things that you get?
I think that's a good solution for now. Could we even do that tomorrow? And or not tomorrow, Thursday and Friday? We just pull it up real quick.
It's the sorting activity on Thursday.
So there's no problem set?
Friday there is one. I think it's triangles, so it's basically the same exact thing with triangles.
Oh, as the day we get back?
Mm-hmm.
So why don't we...
I don't remember if I draw them or not. I'm assuming so.
Yeah.
But the top part is almost the same thing. I have it in the PowerPoint, too.
Oh, great.
PowerPoint for lesson 2 says, find the triangles and color them blue. Put an X on the shapes that are not triangles, and then they have to draw some triangles.
Top right.
Great. So we could do this Friday, and then tomorrow, the Thursday, is just this, right?
I can make something if you want me to, like color the shapes without a curve or something.
Is this in their workbook?
It is, but it is. But not like, we'll need to cut the shapes out for them because I'm cutting from the table on it.
What if, to save you time and to like still do this, what if this is what we do on the rug, like with everybody? Everybody gets a shape on Thursday. That's the problem set, is like independently sorting, and then they go back to their table and they have to draw one shape of it, and then you can debrief that on the stay on the rug. And then go back to your table, draw one shape with a curve, one shape that was straight. And then Friday, split it up, like,
the first half
and the second half.
Okay.
I do think that drawing the shapes, though, especially for some of my kids with, like, OT needs, isn't necessarily a fair, I mean, I can look at the whole thing, too.
Yeah.
But I'm thinking of Raymond, who can, I'm sure can identify a triangle, but there's not a chance they can draw a triangle.
Yeah. I don't think this is a long-term solution.
Okay.
Just for this week.
Okay, no, that's
until
fine.
Like
I'm just like, don't think, yeah.
I'm in the same boat.
Yeah.
But I like not having to make anything extra.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
I'm okay.
Okay. So let's do that for this week, and then, as we can think about next steps, that's one thing that I will get back to everybody about, as well as what this assessment will look like and how we'll assess. Any other, like, based on what you've read, what we've talked about, next steps for you, or like how you want to teach shapes in the next 2 weeks?
Clarify about materials for Thursday's lesson. What are we going to sort? Sounds like not everybody has like objects.
Everyone have the solid, oh no, it doesn't matter. Actually, yeah, solid shapes from last year would work.
Okay.
It doesn't need to be flat.
Okay.
I don't
think it'll make
sense. I don't know if we do, I can look.
Yeah, those have been purchased in the last, some of them have been purchased in the last year or two, so they really should exist. I can help you look for them.
Yeah, they're in a box. I mean, your person should have them in a box. So.
Yeah, I think for this week, it's like pattern blocks, solid shapes that you have, will work because it's not, we're not like flat and solid, it's curve and then triangles.
Okay.
And then Tanisha or whoever here, I know the set in Columbia is really good. I just don't know where it's from.
Where to
order.
It's like a puzzle,
the blue ones.
That's from
a lot from.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I've been trying to look for like not too expensive ones.
Yeah. And?
$17 per set.
That's what we gotta do.
Okay. But that's just flat.
Yeah.
So it's not with solid.
Yeah.
So I assume that everyone has solid.
Okay, so next step, everyone make sure you have solid.
Yeah.
And then, Tanisha, if you wanna
try to order
flat
shapes. Okay.
Yeah. Any other things you're thinking about? Like you wanna go make sure you do?
Either today.